Hey guys, welcome back to another YouTube video. I got broads in Atlanta, just at the lean the family, credit cards in the scammers, hitting the licks in the family, legacies, family. If you don't know me, my name is Miles, and I make videos and do flips. Now, I don't think I've done any videos with this blazer since the day that I bought it, and if you've been watching my videos, you'll see the video when I bought this, and you'll know that... It's very quiet, so today I'm gonna fix that temporarily. Boom, there we go. Okay, I put it up on that so I have more room to get underneath. So actually, this is actually gonna be really easy. It's just gonna be temporary. But if you see right there, that's right before you get to the muffler, and there's just two bolts right there. I think I can unbolt that and it'll make it a lot louder for now. And then if I ever wanna put it back, all I have to do is put those two bolts back in and it'll be an easy temporary thing that'll only take like 2 minutes to take off. But for now, I gotta let that cool down because it's really hot because I was just driving it around. But real quick, if you were wondering what you were seeing in the backup camera, this is my flag holders right here. I have to paint it yet, but me and my friend just made this. We just welded some scrap metal together and it cost like $5 rather than $100. And I just need to like cut this, make it look nicer and then paint it. But I'll show you what the flags look like then. Right now I gotta let this cool down and then I'm gonna unbolt the exhaust. All right, so it's been about an hour, maybe an hour and a half, and I'm gonna check this now and it should be cooled off enough. Let's see. Oh yeah, we're good. So I'm gonna get the wrenches and we're gonna take these two bolts off. All right, so I got the right size wrenches here. And it's a little bit weird because the size of the nut is a little bit bigger than the size of the head of the bolt. So I got two different size wrenches, but I got it figured out now. So let's see. It's actually coming really easily right now. Move over here to the other side. Boom, one down, one more to go. Boom, there we go, got them both out. I'm not really sure what to do with this right now, because it's just kind of hanging here. But for now, I'm just gonna kind of push it back a little bit, maybe keep it from rattling as much as possible. Okay, so that literally took like 2 seconds to do, super easy, super quick, and now the car should sound like 10 times better. Let's find out. Oh yeah. Definitely sounds a lot better. You're not just hearing the fan in the front anymore, you're actually able to hear the exhaust. Nice catch there, other mailbox. Though, as you can tell, it's way louder. And also, those flags are pretty sweet. We're flying pretty good. So I have to run to the store real quick to pick up some oil, and I also need to get gas because I don't know if you can see that, but I'm literally on empty. So hopefully I can even make it to the gas station. I'm pretty sure I will, but we'll see. So I just made it to the store. I'm gonna run in and get some oil and I'll be back soon. All right, we got the oil. So I'm gonna head home and change the oil. All right, guys, made it back home. Got the oil, got my gas, got everything I need, and we're gonna change the oil now. Now I just drove a pretty long ways, so to climb underneath there with it not being very high off the ground would be kind of dangerous because it's gonna be really warm under there. So I'm just gonna let it sit for a little while and let it cool down again. And then we'll do the oil change, which will also give the sun some time to go down, maybe even behind the trees. Maybe I'll wait till a little bit later when the sun's down so it's a little cooler out here, because right now it is pretty hot. So what you're gonna wanna do first is make sure you get the right oil. So you're gonna wanna read to your owner's manual, make sure you're getting the right oil for your car. Now in my case, that oil is 5W30. So that's what I got, so we're gonna change it now. All right, so I put my blocks under the front this time because all the work that I'm gonna be doing is gonna be up in the front here. I let it sit for a little while and it's cooled off now, so I should be good to work under here, which is good that I let it cool off, because right there is the exhaust and right there is where I'm gonna be working. So you don't have to put gloves on for this, but I'm going to because I don't really want to get oil all over my hands, so I'm just putting them on just in case. So our first step here is we're going to pop the hood open. So now that we got the hood open, you're gonna want to go to your engine oil cap. You're gonna want to find your engine oil cap and you're gonna want to open that up. Just keep that open to relieve any pressure so all your oil can run out smoothly. So you're going to want to make sure you find the right wrench for your bolt up here. In this case, it's a 15 millimeter socket that I'm using. And then you want your oil pan down here to catch the oil. And then I also have a rag just in case I need it. So let's start loosening this up. There we go. Now I can do it by hand from there. So you see it starting to drip there. Now I'm gonna hold it in until I get it all the way unscrewed. I might have to adjust your pan a little, and then I'm just gonna let it come out. Now see how I got oil on my hands? That's why I'm wearing these gloves. Now I'm just gonna let this drain, and I'll be back when it's done. My bolt here, I'm gonna clean that off with a rag, make sure I get it all nice and clean. You can see now that this is just dripping. So I think I can put my bolt back in. So I'll screw this back in here and take my wrench and get it on there nice and tight. And then I'm just gonna clean around it with my rag. And now we move up to change the oil filter. So as you can see, right here is my oil filter, and I got this tool right here, which is really nice. It works for many different sizes. So we're gonna put this on here and loosen this up. All right, so it's starting to get loose here. I should be able to do it with my hand here. There we go. Make sure you have your oil pan underneath it because oil is gonna come out. And then once you get that off, dump out all the oil. And then you wanna get rid of your old oil filter. I'm also going to take my rag and clean this up here where the old oil was. Now I'm gonna put on some new gloves because I'm done handling the old oil and I'm now handling the new oil that I got. So I wanna make sure I change my gloves. Now I'm gonna take my new oil filter, pop that out, and then I'm gonna take my new oil, open that up, and I'm just gonna take some of this new oil, put it on the tip of my finger here, and then just wipe it around that seal on the new oil filter. And then once that's done, we're gonna reinstall this new oil filter. All right, so I'm gonna take the new oil filter here and we're gonna screw it right in here. And then once it starts to get tight like that, you wanna go another turn and a half. like that. There we go. And now our new oil filter is installed. So now we just have to put the new oil in the car. All right, so I'm gonna take my funnel here, stick it in the hole, and then grab my new oil, open that up, and I just wanna start dumping that in because this is gonna take a lot of oil. Now make sure you're dumping it in the right place, because if you don't dump it in the right place, that would be really bad. Now also what you want to do is keep checking your oil so you don't overfill it. So wipe that off so it's nice and clean. And then we're just gonna stick that right back down in there. Pull it back out. Give it a look. All right, so we have to keep adding. And crack open the next quart, dump that in. There we go. That right there, 6 quarts that's in there. I am gonna check the oil again. Pull this out, get her nice and clean. Again, now I'm also not on a level surface right now because I'm parked on these ramps. And it looks like we are good. Don't need to add any more oil. So I'm gonna stick that back in, pull out my funnel, and I'm gonna shove my rag in my funnel. Make sure I clean that off. That way I can use it again. Now I'll put my oil cap back in. There we go. And now I'm gonna start it up and then just do a quick look over and make sure everything is good. All right, so let's start this up. Okay, check and see. Everything looks good. Those lights are always on, so everything looks good. I used to have a service engine soon light on, and that's not on right now, so that looks good. Let's check underneath. Looks good, nothing's leaking out of there. All right, everything looks good here. Yeah, we're looking good. So I'll let this run for a little, and then I'll check the oil again and see if I have to add anything. This was definitely in need of an oil change. Look at the old oil. That's pretty bad. So what I'm gonna do with this oil is I'm gonna put the old oil into these containers and then we can recycle them. All right, I'm gonna pull this down on the flat ground so I get a good accurate reading. Go. Just shut it off. And we're gonna check the oil again. All right, let's pull this out. Wipe it off. And it looks like we're good. I'm gonna put that back in. All right, so I moved to a location where if I spill a little bit of oil, it's not that big of a deal. It's not gonna kill any grass or anything. And I'm gonna take this funnel here and I'm gonna put the old oil into my oil container from my new oil that I just used. There we go. Put your cap on it, and then you can take and recycle your old oil. Now you wanna make sure you label this old oil so that you don't go in and accidentally put it in your car again. Just like that. I'm just gonna write that all around it. And I'm also writing do not use. That way you don't accidentally put it back in your car. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is how you change your oil. It's actually really easy to do, and by doing it yourself, you save yourself some money. So that was just a short little tutorial on how to change your oil and also how to make your car louder in 2 minutes without spending any money. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe and stay tuned for more videos about cars and flips and whatever. We'll see you next time. Peace out.